हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम, आई एम पुष्पक पंडित एंड यू आर वाचिंग मी ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल बीइंग बुकिश। ओके, सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिड 3 वीडियोस ऑन हाउ टू सॉल्व मोमेंट ऑफ फोर्स क्वेश्चन एंड बेसिकली आई ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन हाउ टू अप्रोच टू न्यूमेरिकल फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग टू द गुड क्वेश्चन। ओके, एंड नाउ इन दिस 4th वीडियो we are at that stage where we can definitely solve the previous year questions of ICSE in which the numerical has came from moment of force concept or the 4th chapter, and that's exactly we are going to do in this chapter, sorry, in this video. Now basically this video is for previous year questions of force, and particularly in this video I am going to solve 2017 and 2018 question paper of this chapter. Okay, so are you ready to start? So take out your notebook and a pen and let's try to solve and find out the answer. Okay, so now let's start. So here is the first question, that is 2017 question, presenting to you in front of your screen. The question is, a uniform half meter rule has a knife edge which is placed at 29 centimeter mark, and there is a weight of 20 gram force which is placed at one end. Now the question is that, first of all, draw the diagram of the arrangement, and second you need to find out the weight of the half meter rule. This is the question of 2017, and first of all I would ask you to give it a try. If you have constantly watching my videos, then I think you would be able to solve this question, because this question means this type of similar question was discussed in my previous video also. And if you have not watched all the 3 videos and you are having very confusion in this chapter, don't worry, I have explained from the beginning question to the good questions also, so you can definitely watch. The link would be provided in the description box. Now let's see the solution part. I hope you have tried. Now according to the question, there is a half meter rule. So I explained you in my previous videos that whenever you would be given a uniform meter rule, that means its length is 100 centimeters, and now the question is that it is a half meter rule. So if it is a half meter rule, the length would be obviously 50 centimeters. Okay, the length would be obviously 50 centimeters. Now the question says that there is a knife which is placed at this 29 centimeter mark. So we have placed, suppose this is a knife, and this knife is placed at 29 centimeter mark, and there is also one thing, that there is a weight of 20 gram force, there is a weight of 20 gram force which is placed at one end. So either this can be this end also, but this end also. So can we make this 20 gram force at any end point? Obviously not, that is not going to be the case. Okay, so first of all, that is the question, that draw the diagram of the arrangement. Now I have already explained you that suppose this is a half meter rule. Okay, if the knife was placed exactly at the middle point of this half meter rule, that is at 25 centimeter mark, the meter rule would have been balanced. Yes, the meter rule would have been balanced, but now as the knife is slight to the right, means at the 29 centimeter mark, so it would be pushing this side, that is this side would go up and this side should have come down. If this side is down, that means what? This is the heavier side and this is the lighter side. If this is pushing this and this side is coming down, that means this is the heavier side because it is coming down, and this is the lighter side because it is going up. So the meter rule in this case would be like this. So where do you think the 20 gram force should be placed so that the meter rule can become in equilibrium? Obviously in equilibrium it should be placed or not, but the question is where should the 20 gram force be placed? Exactly this side so that at least this should come down and it should try to make it in equilibrium. And exactly that is what we are going to do. So we are going to place this 20 gram force this side. Okay, so I have placed this 20 gram force this side, and this is the diagram of the first question which demands the diagram of the arrangement, and this is what the diagram looks like. The second question demands that what is the weight of the half meter rule. Now I've already told you that whenever you would be asked that what is the weight of the meter rule, in this case we have half meter rule because this is a half meter rule. Remember, again I am telling you that the weight of meter rule acts at the center of meter rule. The weight of meter rule acts at the center. So what is the center here? It is 25 centimeter. So the weight of meter rule would be acting here. Now what is that weight that we need to find out? Okay, so the question first of all says that the meter rule is in equilibrium, yes, or horizontally. It is written that it is placed horizontally. I have told you that when it is told a meter rule is horizontally or it is balanced, that means what? It is trying to say that it is in equilibrium position. It is in equilibrium position. So we know that in equilibrium, we know that total clockwise movement is equal to total anti-clockwise movement, yes or no? This is the formula we have known. So what is the which force is trying to do the clockwise and which it is trying to anti-clockwise? First let us analyze that. So I hope that this is trying to produce a clockwise movement, yes or no? This is trying to produce a clockwise movement, and obviously this is trying to produce an anti-clockwise movement. So now tell me, what is the formula of moment of force? It is force into perpendicular distance, and here also force into perpendicular distance. Now total clockwise moment, this is the clockwise moment. What is the value of force? 20 gram force. And what is the perpendicular distance? Again I will tell you that perpendicular distance is always taken from the pivoted point. For our consideration or for this question, the pivoted point is this 29 centimeter mark. So what is the distance of this 20 gram force from the pivoted point? I think it is 21 centimeter. Yes. Now what is the value of force 2? Means this we do not know, so let it be force 2. But what is the perpendicular distance? That we know, it is 4 centimeter, 25 and 29, that is 4 centimeter. Now what is the value of force? So it is 20 into 21 divided by 4. So 4 5s are, and 21 into 5 is 105 gram force, which is your answer. So this is the required solution that how we will find the weight of the meter rule. So this is the required solution, and I hope that each one of you have understood, and it's a easy question only if you know the basic concept. So kindly note down if you require. Now let's look at the second question, which is 2018 question. Here is the question which will appear in front of you. It says that there is a half meter rule which is pivoted at its midpoint. Now there are two forces, which are 20 gram force and 12 gram force, which are placed respectively at 6 centimeter and 10 centimeter from the pivoted point. That is the question, and the diagram is given like this, I hope. Okay, so this is the required diagram. Now there are three questions. The first question is, which of the two forces acting on the rigid rod produces clockwise moment? The second question is the rod in equilibrium? And the third question says that if the 20 gram force weight is reversed, okay, the direction of the 20 gram force is reversed, then what is the resultant magnitude of the force, total moment of the two forces? Okay, resultant we need to find out. So now let's come back and let's see the diagram again. This is the half meter rule. So if it is a half meter rule, so the total length would be 50 cm and this should be 25 cm because it is pivoted at its midpoint. So if it is pivoted at its midpoint, then the midpoint is 25 cm obviously. There are two forces, here is a 20 gram force and here is a 12 gram force, and they are placed 6 cm from the pivoted point. From the pivoted point, this is 6 cm and this is 10 cm far apart. Now the first question is very easy, that which of the two forces is producing a clockwise moment? Which of the two forces is producing a clockwise moment? So this force is trying to produce clockwise moment and this force is trying to produce an anti-clockwise moment. So basically the first answer will be 12 gram force. Okay, so the force of 12 gram force is trying to produce a clockwise moment. Okay, now the second question says whether the rod is in equilibrium or not. So let's do the calculation. We know that if they are in equilibrium, let us directly solve. I am not going to write the steps. Let us directly solve. If the rod is in equilibrium, total clockwise moment will be equal to the total anti-clockwise moment. So total clockwise moment is this. So force, what is the value of force? Force into perpendicular distance will be equals to this total anti-clockwise moment. So what is the force value? 20 gram force into 6. So this will be 120 and this is also 120. I am not writing the unit. Let us directly, we are directly interested in the answer. So both of them are coming same. That means what? The rod is in equilibrium. So if the rod is in equilibrium, our answer is yes, the rod is in equilibrium. The third and the last question is, if the direction of this 20 gram force is reversed. It is reversed, that means what? Now it is acting this side. Okay, it is acting this side and the 20 gram force is placed this side. 20 gram force is acting now this side. Now what would be the resultant moment of force? Is it going to be the same or what? First of all, it is not going to be the same. Why? Because now this is also producing a clockwise moment. This was earlierly producing a clockwise moment and now this is also going to produce a clockwise moment, means both are going to be added. And if they are going to be the added, then obviously the answer is going to be different. Previously, let me tell you something more, that previously if we calculate, then this force is producing this side 120 force and this is producing 124. So though both of them were cancelling each other, both of them were cancelling each other because they were equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. But now both are in same direction. So what is the resultant moment of force? So this was also 20. Okay, this was also 120 and this is also 120. Now the total resultant moment of force would be what? Total resultant moment of force is equals to 120 plus 120, which is 240 gram force centimeter. This is the required answer. Basically, if you want to give your answer more accurately, then this would be negative. This answer is minus 240 gram force centimeter. Now, can anyone tell me why this is negative? Obviously, because it is a clockwise moment and we know that clockwise moments are taken negative. So the correct answer would be minus 240 gram force centimeter, or you can write 240 gram force centimeter and in bracket you can write clockwise. Okay, so this is the required solution for this 2018 question, and it was just a bit tricky in the last question, otherwise it was a good question. So if you want to write it down, kindly write it down. Okay, so friends, that's all from this video. I hope that solving board questions of previous year definitely boosts your confidence and it helps you to gather more knowledge and it helps you to be comfortable with the board question. So after uploading 4 videos on the moment of force or the force chapter on how to solve its numericals, I hope that these 4 videos are sufficient to solve and to know how to solve the numericals. And in the next videos of physics, I am definitely going to take the second chapter and show you that how you can solve those concept related questions. Okay, so if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and if the video was helpful, do not forget to like and share this video. So we'll meet you in the next video. Take care and thank you.